So Copenhagen Atomics molten salt reactor will actually burn nuclear waste. And then to deploy them in a 40-foot shipping container, the world's already set up. Literally the whole world is set up to handle 40-foot shipping containers. This makes it fast to build, fast to deploy. It's everything that current nuclear isn't. My name is Ben. I'm originally from Australia. I work at Copenhagen Atomics as a loop technician. So before working at Copenhagen Atomics, I've had a fairly long career in fixing broken stuff. It's what I really enjoy, actually, is fixing things in the middle of nowhere using all the wrong tools. So the philosophy we work by at Copenhagen Atomics is with rapid innovation cycles. So we like to design it fairly quick, then get to building it, test it, break it, and then back to the design, go again. So the big advantage of building things is that you learn a lot more, a lot faster than if we just stayed in the design phase. And that way, we get better at what we do, as well as the product also gets better. It does mean that we'll achieve the goal faster than others, just because we are actually doing it. And so the latest evidence of this is seen in loop 6.0, which is a full-scale test loop that uses water as its medium. It's also built in a shipping container that is very similar to how we'll build commercial reactors. So loop 6.0 is a culmination of all the knowledge that we've gained from the previous loops, going way back to what the founders built, zeros and ones, which I believe they built in their garage. They sort of look like beer kegs. So to build loop 6.0 was perhaps surprisingly easy. So we already had a lot of this knowledge from our testing that we'd already done. There was definitely things that we learnt, but it was a very straightforward exercise, a few days exercise to actually assemble it all and to get it from water. So loop 6.0 has a core that will run the same as what we will run in our test reactor, as well as 7 pumps, all the electronics and a couple of tanks. So the only things missing from loop 6.0 compared to a test reactor is some insulation and heaters. So the testing on 6.0 is, we're always testing the software and electronics. So it runs pretty much 24/7. How's the flow look? Yeah. See in the turbine is the purple one? Look at that. Then on top of that, we run more dynamic tests with pumps and flow. So seeing how water flows through the core, coming back to tanks, and how the pumps respond. So the next steps from 6.0 have already begun. We're building 6.1. a full-scale molten salt test reactor. So you can see the difference with 6.0 is it's open-sided, open-topped, whereas 6.1 is a closed shipping container. This is some of the reason that we've tested so much in the last years, because once you close that shipping container up and heat it, it takes a long time to heat, takes a lot of energy to heat. You have to be fairly certain it's going to work.